Hey, welcome to Apple A Day. In today's Apple Motion episode, we're going to be talking about replicators, shapes, and colors over patterns. Here's the end result of today's tutorial. All of this is done using a single tiny rectangle replicated hundreds of times. The illusion of movement is controlled by color and the rate property behavior. With using only this, many, many amazing effects can be achieved. So the first thing we're going to do is create a round corner rectangle with a moving dashed border. To start, we need a particle that we're going to replicate. So I'm going to create a tiny little rectangle using the rectangle tool. Just like that. We're going to rename this to particle. Then we're going to select replicate in the top right. Let's name this replicator to dashed line. Now let's reset the position by going to the inspector, properties. Under position, I'm going to click on the drop-down arrow and select reset parameter, and that will center it on the screen. Now we need to change the replicator shape from a rectangle to instead use the geometry of another shape. So I'm going to click on replicator, and where it says shape, and rectangle, I'm going to change that to geometry. So now we have to assign a shape to the geometry of this replicator. So let's create a large rectangle. I'm going to set the name to round rect. Oops. And in the properties, I'm going to reset the position to be right in the center. And under shape and style, I'm going to turn off the fill, and I guess we can leave the outline on so we can see it. And under geometry, I'm going to change the roundness to 50, so we have a nice round cornered rectangle. Now I'm going to select the dashed line replicator and click on the round rect shape, dragging it onto the shape source of the replicator. Since we don't need to see the original shape of the round rectangle we created, I'm going to hide that by unchecking it. And if I deselect everything, we can see a few dots in the viewer. We need to dramatically increase the number of points produced by the replicator. So select the dashed line and go to the replicator tab and type in 1000 in the points property. And you can see it filled up the round rect shape completely. So next, we need to create a dashed line. The easiest way to do that is to create a repeating color pattern where the opacity toggles between 100 and 0. Simulating a broken or a dashed line. So with the dashed line replicator selected, let's go to the replicator tab. We're already in there. And go down to color mode and change it from original to over pattern. And you can see the outline already changed. It's going from white and gradually fading to blue based on this default color gradient. So we're going to open up the color gradient details and create a new opacity marker roughly at the halfway point. So I can do that just by clicking on the top white line, which is the opacity line, and that creates a new marker right there. I'm going to click on that marker, and I'm going to change the opacity from 100 down to 0. And you can see that that line fades out. And in this first example, I want the dashes to be solid white. So the bottom bar represents the color. So I'm going to click on the first color, and I'm going to change that to white. And I'm going to click on the far right color here and change that to white as well. So the line is solid white. Of course, it's still fading down to black. So in order to fix that, we need to change the interpolation from continuous to constant. So I'm going to select the first opacity marker. And where it says interpolation, I'm going to change that to constant. And now we have a solid line. It does not fade out. It starts here and ends over there. Of course, that's not much of a dashed line border. We need to increase the number of repetitions of this color pattern. Right now, it's set to 0. So to increase the number of repetitions, we can just go down to the color repetitions property, select the value, and drag to the right. And you can see the number of dashes increasing. You can also type in an absolute number. I'm just going to highlight that and type in 50. That looks pretty good. Now you can also adjust the width of these dashes by changing the position of the opacity marker. If I drag the zero opacity marker to the left, it's going to make those dashes shorter. And conversely, if I drag it way to the right, it makes the dashes longer. But I kind of like where it was, roughly in the middle. And of course, you can set that to be a specific location down here in the location property. I can just type in 50. And that puts it smack dab in the center. So now we need to animate the dashes and show them moving. So if we adjust the offset value up here, you can see how the dashes appear to move because we're changing the starting position. So in order to animate this, we need to add a parameter behavior. So I'm going to click on the drop-down arrow here next to the offset property and choose Add Parameter Behavior and select Rate. And here I'm just going to give it a value of 10%. So if I press play, we have moving dashes. I'm going to slow that down a little bit by selecting rate and dropping it to 5%. Put it back to the beginning, hit play, and that looks pretty good. Of course, you can make it go in the opposite direction just by typing in minus 5. Now it's going counterclockwise. I'm going to put it back to clockwise. That's pretty good. That's the effect we wanted. What's really cool is you can see the line follow the contour of the curve of the rounded rectangle. So I'm going to move the playhead back to the beginning. I'm going to show you another example. This also works with an open curve. So let's create a quick path using the pen tool. I'm going to make a starting point here. I'm going to move up and over, click, and then hold the shift key down and drag to constrain the handles to make a perfect tangent. I'm going to make another point over here, click, shift key, and drag to make another perfect tangent. And then I'm going to end the curve right about here, basically making a really rough sine wave. I'm going to rename it to sine wave. Turn off the fill. I'm also going to turn off the outline. That's another way to hide it. Select the dash line replicator. Click and drag the sine wave onto the shape source for the replicator. And now instantly that replicator is using the new path we just created. So if I hit play, you can see it's working the same way as it did in the round corner rectangle, except we do see more dashes on here. And that's because the full length of that path is shorter in the sine wave than it was in the rectangle. So I could just go down to dashed line and reduce the number of repetitions to say 25. And that's more of the effect I was looking for. What's really cool is how the dashes seem to appear and disappear at the beginning and end of the path. And that's just going to go on indefinitely, or at least until the end of the timeline. Now, you can also do some interesting things with colors. Let's say we wanted these dashes to be red, white, and blue. So I'm going to select the dashed line replicator again. I'm going to select the first color marker and change it to red. I'm going to make another color marker right about here, and I'm going to change that to white. And then the last color marker, I'm going to change that to blue. I'm also going to drag that over so it's in line with the zero opacity marker, right about there. And if you look at the dashed line, now it's red, white, and blue. So that looks pretty good. And you can see again how the dotted line follows that curve very nicely. One thing to notice, though, is that the colors do fade into each other. It's not a hard cutoff between the red, the white, and the blue. They sort of blend into each other. I'm going to fit this back to the window. And in order to fix that, we can have those colors change abruptly, just like what we did with opacity. So I'm going to select the red color And under interpolation, I'm going to select constant. I'm going to do the same thing with white. And now something interesting happened. It doesn't change to blue until after the opacity is set to zero. So we need to make some adjustments here and move the white over and then move the blue over. So they're each taking up about a third of that area. And if I blow this up, you can see the colors have nice hard edges. They change abruptly. I'm going to increase the speed of that. So that looks pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. So the last example I want to show is how this works with a slightly more complicated path. So I've copied in a rocket ship path, which is slightly more intricate than the round corner box and, of course, the sine wave. And I'm going to drag this into the dashed line replicators shape source. And I'm also going to hide the rocket ship layer so we don't see the original outline. And if I hit play, it looks pretty neat. You can see the lines going around the shape. Nothing too different so far. Next, I want to reset the color gradient back to black and white. So I'm going to select red, change that to white. Get rid of the blue marker just by dragging it off and then moving the white one all the way to the end. I'm also going to change the number of repetitions down to 10 so the lines are longer. It makes for an interesting effect, having the dashed lines a little bit longer. So what I want to do is actually have each dashed line fade out. So I'm going to select the first opacity marker and reset that interpolation from constant back to continuous. And you can see how the lines fade out. But I want the fade to be longer, so I'm going to move the middle marker closer to the beginning so the fade out is longer. So it stays solid white to about here, and then it fades from this point to the zero opacity marker. And then if I drag that zero opacity marker over to the right, the fade becomes even more gradual. I'm going to drag it just before the end. So if I press play now, I just realized it's going the wrong way. We want this to go counterclockwise because we want it to look like those lines are fading out, kind of like a comet. It should fade in the direction away from which it's traveling. So I'm going to select rate and change that to minus 10. Press play again. There we go. So that's kind of an interesting effect. Well, that's pretty much all I wanted to go over today. As you can see, you have countless options when working with the over-pattern color mode for replicators. By tweaking just a handful of properties, you can make some very interesting effects. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on replicators. Thanks, as always, for watching. I'm John Martins. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next episode of Apple a Day.